As the parade of graduates approaches, we salute the states and territories whose sons and daughters will graduate today.
Delaware.
Pennsylvania. New Jersey.
Georgia. Connecticut. Massachusetts.
Maryland.
South Carolina.
New Hampshire.
Virginia. New York.
North Carolina. Rhode Island. Vermont.
Kentucky. Tennessee. Ohio. Louisiana. Indiana.
Mississippi.
Illinois. Alabama. Maine. Missouri.
Arkansas. Michigan.
Florida. Texas. Iowa. Wisconsin.
California. Minnesota.
Oregon. Kansas. West Virginia. Nevada. Nebraska.
Colorado. North Dakota.
South Dakota. Montana. Washington.
Idaho.
Wyoming. Utah.
Oklahoma.
New Mexico. Arizona.
Alaska.
Hawaii. District of Columbia. Puerto Rico.
Guam.
American Samoa. Northern Mariana Islands. Virgin Islands.
State flags. Order. Arms. And now we invite you to join the staff of Recruit Training Command in welcoming the graduating divisions with your applause as they enter Midway Ceremonial Hall and are announced in the following order.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise to welcome today's graduating divisions. Division 913 provides the state flag, color guard, and drumline units for today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Thank you. Divisions. Right. Face. Section leaders. Fall out and collect outer guards. Divisions. Counter. March. Attention, please. For the remainder of the review, no one will be permitted to pass in front of the review stand, and we ask this as a courtesy to our reviewing officer. Photography is certainly encouraged, but we ask that you remain seated and off the drill deck. Photographers you will see on deck throughout the review are the official photographers of Recruit Training Command.
Thank you.
Division commanders, left or right, face, parade, rest.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm Lieutenant Kellen Lewis, Recruit Training Command's Field Division Officer. I would like to welcome you to today's passing review. Today, you see 10 divisions comprised of 820 sailors participate in the graduation ceremony and soon join the most powerful Navy in the world. Please draw your attention to the unit position at center deck. There is the review commander and staff. The review commander is responsible for conducting the graduation ceremony. Today's review commander is Senior Recruit Kapua Dumarin from Copper's Cove, Texas. Let's give him a hand, folks. Performing today is a staff unit on their 8th week of training, the triple threat unit on their 9th week of training, and the state flag unit on their 10th and final week of training. These units are comprised entirely of recruits. During their night of arrival, recruits are placed in divisions of 88 personnel and assigned division commanders. Recruit division commanders form the backbone of recruit training and are key individuals in the life of every recruit. Division commanders will serve as counselors, disciplinarians, administrators, and military leaders. Above all, they must show themselves as outstanding examples of military bearing, appearance, attitude, and behavior. Each division also has a recruit chief petty officer. The senior recruit supervises the divisional staff positions and leads the division in the absence of their division commanders. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the graduating divisions, the division commanders, and the recruit chief petty officers. As I introduce each division, they will raise the competitive flags they have earned throughout their training. As I introduce each recruit chief petty officer, the flag representing their home state will also be raised. Please hold your applause until all introductions have been completed. I will be starting from there, right. Division 099. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer David Alvarado. Petty Officer First Class John Medichino. Petty Officer First Class Orlando Lugo. Petty Officer Second Class Dionysia Simmons. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Austin Christoph from Killeen, Texas. Division 101. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Edison Owen. Petty Officer First Class Zachary Cornwall. Petty Officer Second Class Kendrick Wallace. Petty Officer Second Class Giovanna Salinas. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Grant Lee from Syracuse, Utah. Division 102. Commanded by Petty Officer First Class Rick Chartier. Petty Officer First Class Sydney Thorne. Petty Officer Second Class Mario Sorcy. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Ashley Whitley from Brandon, Mississippi. Division 103. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Ramon Cicada. Petty Officer First Class Richard Franco. Petty Officer First Class Carlos Rodriguez. Petty Officer Second Class Jonathan Ortiz. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Justin Kingsley from Lancaster, California. Division 10. Chief Petty Officer Joshua Goolsby. Petty Officer Second Class Tyvon Furman. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Latarius Stowers from Covington, Georgia. Division 105. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Kelly Ringman. Chief Petty Officer Marcus Pastra. Petty Officer Second Class Joshua Jameson. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Caitlin Dusek from Round Rock, Texas. Division 106. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Johnny Payano Mendez. Chief Petty Officer Ron Jean. Petty Officer First Class Catherine Fleming. Petty Officer Second Class Brady Arnes. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Alexander Baker from Lake Tahoe, Nevada. Division 107. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Brett Hull. Petty Officer First Class Jesse Walborn. Petty Officer Second Class Asia Barnes. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Zachary Gebhardt from Detroit, Michigan. Division 108. Commanded by Senior Chief Petty Officer Jose Benitez. Chief Petty Officer Jason Lacey. Petty Officer First Class Christopher Wilson. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Joseph Burr from Houston, Texas. Division 913. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Barbara Harris. Petty Officer First Class Austin Lloyd. Petty Officer Second Class Sibel Usman. Petty Officer Second Class Angel Cabrera. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Jackson Kudron from St. Louis, Missouri. On behalf of the Commanding Officer and Staff of Recruit Training Command, we congratulate these Division Commanders and Recruit Chief Petty Officers on a job well done. In a moment, we'll see the ceremonial side boys, boatswain, and honor guard take their places for arrival honors. This time on the suggestion is our formal greeting to this morning's reviewing officer. When requested by the announcer, please stand for the arrival honors, marching under the colors, the national anthem, and the invocation. As a reminder, military guests shall remain covered throughout the entire graduation ceremony. And ladies and gentlemen, one final note. As befitting the importance of the occasion, our ceremony is conducted in a formal manner. However, we do encourage you to participate in today's graduation ceremony by letting your applause show these sailors just how proud of them you are. Once again, welcome aboard.
the guests please rise and remain standing for the arrival of the official party? Recruit Training Command, arriving. Naval Service Training Command, arriving. Secretary of Defense for Personnel and Readiness, arriving. Guests may be seated.
Thank you.
Present. Arms. Present. Arms. Order, arms. Chaplain Brindier will now offer this morning's invocation.
Let us pray. Gracious God, source of light and strength, we ask you for your blessing today on this training command, that it continue true to the high outcomes and purposes of shaping sailors. These sailors that stand before us stand before you. May this be the brand new day in which they are convinced that devotion, sacrifice, and service for the greater good is honorable and worthy. As they've committed to a great work, may they sense your blessing and presence. Their success was earned, not given. Transformation has been a process here. Embracing challenges and adversity, their growth brings us joy and gives us strength, especially for our shared way of life. We're proud of their hard work over the past weeks and months. For those who shaped them into finely equipped, smartly disciplined sailors, to those RDCs, instructors, staff, may they receive a blessing this day. To the families, the mentors, coaches, who cheered them on, supported them, may they experience a deep measure of gratitude and pride in this moment. As at all times, but especially those in moments of conflict or turmoil, we're preparing ready guardians of peace. So we ask you to pour out courage and wisdom for these newest sailors. May they be unswerving in duty, resolute in defending democracy, determined to do good to all. Now I ask you each grant for each one humility, steadfast purpose, and a deep hope. Amen.
Amen.
point, the commanding officer would issue orders and instructions to the unit commanders. Then, the unit commanders would face about and relay the information to their divisions. Today's event shall orders are passed to the chain of command.
Divisions, report! Very well. Very well.
Division 102, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well.
Division 103, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well.
Division 104, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well.
Division 105, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well.
Division 106, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well.
Division 107, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well. Very well.
Division 943, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well. All divisions, prisoner or accounted for, sir.
Very well.
Thank you.
Sir!
Good morning. I'm Captain Jeff Sandin, the Commanding Officer of Recruit Training Command. I'm pleased to welcome families and friends to our graduation ceremony and look forward to sharing this momentous occasion with everyone. With us today is our reviewing officer, the Honorable Gilbert R. Cisneros, Jr., Undersecretary of Defense for Personnel and Readiness. Rear Admiral Jennifer S. Kucher, Commander, Naval Service Training Command, and our guest of honor, Captain Stephen DeMost, Commander, Surface Group, Western Pacific. While we are restricted on occupancy, it is important that you are here today to celebrate your sailor's significant milestone. Your support during these unprecedented times has helped us to complete the mission of transforming civilians into sailors while operating in a safe environment to help ensure fleet readiness. I cannot thank you enough for your continued support, and I'm sure your sailors are grateful for your encouragement throughout their training. I would also like to welcome all of our veterans in the audience for their service to our country. Would all of our veterans please stand so we can give them a round of applause. Division 913 graduates today. They're the Staff Flags Unit, providing 50 state flags, District of Columbia, and U.S. Territory flags, Drum Corps, and Color Guard. Please join me in giving them and the 9 other graduating divisions here today a round of applause for their outstanding performances. I would also like to give a special congratulations today to all the sailors in this training group who are the first to complete the new 10-week basic military training program. The additional 2 weeks include Sailor for Life training, providing recruits with additional focus and recruit mentorship, small unit leadership, advanced warrior toughness training, as well as professional and personal development. Every recruit now graduates with more tools and skills to make them more effective and combat-ready sailors. This is where our Navy heritage meets the future and where these young men and women enter the profession of arms. The staff of Recruit Training Command are dedicated to providing the United States Navy with basically trained, physically fit, and smartly disciplined sailors, such as those standing here before you this morning. These sailors have successfully completed 10 weeks of demanding recruit training. They have earned the right to wear the uniform recognized throughout the world as a symbol of freedom. They, and others like them, have served as a bedrock of our naval forces. They will join other sailors around the world to give our Navy its combat edge and enable us to help keep this nation secure. This training group is ready to graduate and serve in the world's most powerful Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you 820 of the newest and sharpest sailors in the United States Navy.
Promotes teamwork, attention to detail, and pride in accomplishment. Divisions performing above standards throughout their training are awarded recognition flags in the five mission areas: academic achievement, military drill, compartment readiness, applications, and physical fitness. These flags are carried as a visible symbol of the division's success. Each flag indicates that your sailors individually and as teams met performance standards in one or more mission areas. A division that excels in every phase of training qualifies for the Battle Efficiency Honor Division recognition and is awarded the Battle E Honor Flag for this exemplary achievement. Division 103 has earned this honor flag. And we congratulate them on the job exceptionally well done. The Honorable Mr. Cisneros will now present this week's individual awards, and he will be joined on the drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Sand, Commander, Naval Service Training Command, Rear Admiral Kucher, and our guest of honor, Captain Demos. For achieving the highest overall academic score during recruit training, Seaman Israel Demings, Division 108, from Anchorage, Alaska, has earned the Academic Excellence Award, which is sponsored by the Lake Defiance Chapter of the Illinois Society of the Sons of the American Revolution. Seaman Demings receives a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor. For having displayed extraordinary qualities, best expressing the American spirit of honor, initiative, and loyalty, Seaman Apprentice Tatiana Avery, Division 105, from Jacksonville, Florida, is awarded the Navy League Award, which is sponsored by the Navy League of the United States. Seaman Apprentice Avery is presented with a commemorative plaque and a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Seaman John Redis, Division 104, from San Jose, California, is the winner of the United Service Organization Award for best exemplifying the spirit and intent of the word shipmate. Seaman Redis is given a commemorative plaque from the United Service Organization. Well done, sailor. Airman Ethan Weaver, Division 099, from Woodbridge, Virginia, is the recipient of the Military Order of the World Wars Award of Merit. This award is presented for meritorious performance during recruit training. Airman Weaver is presented with a commemorative plaque from the Military Order of the World Wars. Well done, sailor.
Captain.
The Military Officers Association Leadership Award is presented to Airman Samantha Heiderman, Division 102, from Moundsville, West Virginia, for demonstrating exceptional tenacity and professionalism. Airman Heiderman is awarded a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Seaman Caitlin Dusek, Division 105, from Round Rock, Texas, is the recipient of the Navy Club of the United States of America Military Excellence Award for best exemplifying the qualities of enthusiasm, devotion to duty, military bearing, and teamwork. This award places her at the pinnacle of today's newest sailors. She is awarded a flag letter of commendation. Seaman Dusek, the Staff Recruit Training Command salutes you as the finest of this group of graduates. Well done, sailor. It is appropriate to recognize such outstanding individual accomplishments by these sailors with a round of three cheers. The adjutant will lead all graduating divisions in three cheers for this morning's award winners.
Hip, hip.
I have the distinct pleasure this morning of introducing a reviewing officer, the Honorable Gilbert R. Cisneros, Jr., Undersecretary of Defense for Personnel and Readiness. Born and raised in Southern California, he is a philanthropist, veterans advocate, member of Congress with national security experience, and a former Navy officer, having been commissioned in 1994. A strong advocate for our service members and our veterans, Mr. Cisnero served on both the Armed Services and Veterans Affairs Committee when he represented California's 39th Congressional District in the House of Representatives. Mr. Cisnero has been an advocate for military families on issues of housing, child abuse, and exceptional family members. As a former Naval officer, he secured language in the National Defense Authorization Act that will evaluate and strengthen the Navy's progress to not only make better warriors, but better ship drivers. He is also the co-founder of the Military Transition Assistance Pathway Caucus to support and advocate on behalf of military service members returning to civilian life. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a warm recruit training command welcome to the Honorable Gilbert R. Cisneros, Jr.
Good morning, everyone. I want to especially thank the families that are here, but I really want to talk to all our new sailors that are here today on this momentous day. 33 years ago, I was standing right where you are right now. In a different location. I actually did boot camp down in San Diego, which is no longer here. But what is going through my mind right now, I was nervous and excited. I'm sure you are feeling those same emotions. But this is a momentous occasion for you. When I look back on this, you are both all better trained, better prepared to join the fleet than I ever was when I got out of boot camp. All those years ago. So you should all be very proud of what you accomplished and what you achieved during these past 10 weeks. I know for a lot of you, they told you it was only going to be 8, and you got a surprise when you got here, and they said, oh, hey, you're staying for an extra 2 weeks, but you You all made it through. So, you know, as the Undersecretary of Personnel Readiness, I am responsible for a lot of policy that deals with our families, our service members, and our civilians, but I'm also in charge of the readiness, making sure that our services, all of them, are ready to fight today and into going into the future. So your training is a big part of this, and what you have accomplished is just amazing. As I leave you here today, just a few words of advice. You know, learn your job when you get out there. Learn how to do your job, learn how to do it well. Listen to your LPOs, listen to your chiefs, because they have a lot of experience and they can teach you. But also, be proud of the work that you do. Be proud of your ship, be proud of your shipmates, and just be proud of your nation. You are all going to go out there and do great things. I owe everything I have to the Navy. It provided me with my education. It provided me with the leadership experience I have. And I look back on my time that I served very fondly. And I know you all do the same one day. So good luck to you. Fair winds and following seas. And I wish you the best of luck. Thank you.
Graduated divisions, and he will be joined on the drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Sandin. Please remain seated until your graduates have been placed on liberty. please join me in one more round of appreciation for our wonderful musicians of Navy Band Great Lakes. Flags, posts, section leaders, fall out and retrieve outer garments. Again, to each and every one of you for joining us on this most memorable of Navy days. Please utilize all safety rails and exit in an orderly fashion. And without further delay, now hear this. Liberty call, liberty call.